You may misunderstand this. It's against the law to complain at this point in time. That's another reason why I didn't answer when they asked me, anong natakbuhan mo? Wala pa. Dahil Nobyembre at 30 pa ang sinasabi ng batas. Pag ikaw ay nagsabi ng ikaw kandidato for any position, to me, you're already violating the law. You're violating the Constitution. Because it is very clear that we must not all prematurely campaign. And unless and until we learn how to follow the rule of law, I feel the problems of the country will remain unsolved and exacerbated year after year. So the basic act of running for public office must be respected in accordance with law. I know one incident, as I was telling Congressman Bowen earlier. In Honolulu, there was a very popular mayor by the name of Jeremy Harris. Very popular so that he beat his opponent by a big landslide. And maybe in the euphoria of this occasion, when he's swearing in, he declared, I'm running for governor in the next election after trouncing his opponent in that manner. Somebody sued him in the Supreme Court of Hawaii and he lost his case. He was unable to run for governor and he was booted out of office. That's the kind of enforcement of our laws that we need today if we are to really inculcate in our people of what is necessary for nation building. Sa ngayon, maraming problema tayo sa bansa na kaugat doon sa ating kahinaan sa pagbibigay gala sa ating mga batas. Ang ating konstitusyon ay malinaw. The rule of law is the basic anchor for every vision, every dream of our constitution to give our people a good life. Not even just a better life, but a good life. Because we have everything that is needed for our economic progress. But we need to now learn how to follow the rule of law and to respect our Constitution. I mentioned this Ordinance 8187 because it is in gross violation of constitutional guarantees. I am facing a forum of constitutionalists. One of the most illustrious organizations of law practitioners, gentlemen who have served our country to the best of your abilities. You have all taken your oaths of office at one time. And you know very well that we must take it seriously when we say we would like to protect and we are committed to protect, preserve, and defend the Constitution. This ordinance is unconstitutional. So we find the case in the Supreme Court, it is now pending. And we're proving beyond doubt that it is unconstitutional not to protect the health of your people and not to enhance the environment in harmony with it. In rhythm and harmony with nature. That's how beautiful our Constitution is crafted and worded. And these are very important provisions of our basic law. The right of each and every citizen to a healthy, clean environment. Ayun pa naman ang point day po. Giving our people a clean and healthy environment that is in rhythm and harmony with nature. If they're committed, and we're committed, a continuing violation of the intentions of our Constitution. It's time today that we correct that and tell the correct message to our people on the relevance and importance of respecting our basic law. I thank the present councillors who are here because they are members of those who oppose the overturning of the ordinance that we prepared. Through them, this present ordinance is now being fought in all levels. Through people's initiative, in the Supreme Court, a massive information campaign to open up the eyes of our lumaki ko sa isang tahan na ang aming ama, halili ng aming pamilya, ang nagturo sa akin. I remember the words of my father always telling me that we have to respect the law. And you must always be following the rule of law. And this is exactly the requirement of our times. Because as I said, we have more than enough resources and natural wealth to provide our people a better life. But we must now also follow all these provisions in the Golden Book of Laws. We have more than 10 provisions to defend, to protect our natural wealth. But unless all of these are implemented and enforced and respected by those who are mandated to do just that, these are all meaningless provisions of our basic law. Kailangan natin ang mga magpapatupad ng ating mga patakaran, ng ating mga batas sa lahat ng sana ng gobyerno, ang wastong paniniwala at matibay ng ating kahit sa pangangailangan ng ating pagsunod sa batas.